The idea to do a history book started officially in 2006. There were a group of us that had an interest in history of the police department. We knew it hadn't been done before. We knew there is a time factor involved with that because as these folks get older, we're losing access to some of the materials as we lose them. And it was important for us to go ahead and move to capture our earliest times now. We wrote the book predominantly because we knew our in-house folks would have an interest, but yet we're well aware that the book should be shared with the public, and we wanted to share the information, the photographs, and the materials that we located and saw with the general public who might have an interest in local history and Fairfax County history. The book has badges, patches, our basic weapon series, cars, motorcycles, helicopters, and a whole appendices full of data and information that a lot of collectors and police enthusiasts, as well as general historians, would have an interest in acquiring. But our key focus was on the early years, starting in 1921, when Carl McIntosh, our first chief, started in law enforcement here in Fairfax County with the sheriff's office. We interviewed numerous retirees for this book. The retiree network, in terms of gathering this information, was exceedingly important. We couldn't have done it without the retirees and our extended police family. The success that we've had to date with the book, I would attribute directly to our retirees and the support that we got from our active staff and the chief and the command staff. We put the word out that we were looking for old photographs, police memorabilia, anything having to do with the FCPD from its starting origins, and the families were very forthcoming, sharing family materials in terms of photographs, uniforms, in some occasions weapons, letting us photograph what they had and document things. The history of Virginia, and Fairfax County included, initially law enforcement was all handled through the sheriff's office. Sheriff's offices have been around in Virginia for a long time, since colonial days. Police departments are more modern advent, where you saw as responsibilities it was necessary to divide those for law enforcement functions and build up our suburban or urban type areas or where congestion required it. You had the advent of police departments. And in Fairfax County, the police department started directly in the 20s because of traffic issues, traffic congestion. And at that point, our officers were called the Special Police, the Road Police, the Traffic Squadron, and the Fairfax County Police. We stayed under the sheriff's office until July 1st, 1940, until we became an independent agency. Technologies has revolutionized the manner in which we are able to police. Now with computers in the cars, I remember when that started in the 1980s, and you were able to have information at your fingertips that would return within seconds when you were running computer checks. It would enhance the ability to arrest, safeguard the population, go after the offenders, and keep a check on people that were potentially problems. It's aided us with traffic control, with the helicopters, in terms of being able to watch traffic patterns and deal with situations as they start to arise. We save lives with the technologies that we use. Our canine teams are well advanced. Our SWAT teams are well advanced. We have some of the best in the nation in terms of personnel and operational capabilities with the teams here in Fairfax County. And all that's evolved over time. And when you look back at our history, that the emphasis that's put on training our officers to be top-notch and have the ability and skill set to deal with whatever they encounter is phenomenal. The first police radio system that was used in Fairfax County was in cooperation with the District of Columbia Police Department. When radios first were put in Fairfax County police squad cars, they were one-way radio receivers. You could not transmit. As time evolved and you got into the Second World War era in the early 1940s, we then came about with the capabilities of two-way radio communication, which just totally enhanced the ability of our officers to respond to calls for service and handle situations as they arose in Fairfax County. In the 1920s and the 1930s, we had our earliest vehicles being motorcycles. There wasn't so much a motor unit as it was police officers simply using motorcycles to patrol and get to different avenues in the county that they needed to and handle situations when something would arise. As time went on in the 1930s, you're starting to see squad cars or police cars through our history, and including the time when we've now become a standalone agency, you have a department that uses a multitude of vehicles, cars, trucks, motorcycles, helicopters, and a whole venue of other vehicles now in our inventory. As the Fairfax County Police Department developed, we started seeing specialization of units. That's first noticeable when our detectives started specializing in certain types of crimes in the 50s and 60s. The first helicopter came about in Fairfax County for police use in the 1970s. This helicopter would seat two individuals. It was used strictly for observation, both for traffic, crime control. The shortcomings of that helicopter was a little underpowered, and there was no way in the world you could fly a medevac with it, so you were really limited in the operational capabilities of that helicopter. The program we have today has medevac capability as well as police mission capability and a lot of other operational abilities that it has that it provides support to the troops with when it's necessary to use it. In addition to the book that we've recently released on the history of the Fairfax County Police Department, the group of retirees that I'm working with, as well as an expanded group, are working to put a Fairfax County Police Museum together. We have in our possession a lot of firearms, pieces of equipment, we have some cruisers, we have different items that would be of general interest to the public. The police department originally started with about four officers in the 1920s for the entirety of Fairfax County. As time went on, we started seeing the population explosion, more officers were brought on. So that first group of four officers has now expanded somewhere between 1,300 and 1,400 sworn, I think, that are actually on our staff. A good example of the rapid growth of the Fairfax County Police, even from 1961, is to look at our headquarters at 10600 Page Avenue. Today, that's an annex building. It's not our headquarters anymore. However, in 1961, it was a state-of-the-art facility, and originally, you could see grass around it and a very, very undeveloped area next to it. 1968, we see the Massey building going up behind it as a new county seat. And then in 2009, you see all these buildings, new growth, expanded jail, and additional court facilities all in this complex. It's just an enormous rapid pace of growth, all based on the needs of Fairfax County. Paula Elsie, she basically is a local publisher of history here in Fairfax County. She's very knowledgeable about the county, the history in the county, and how to put a wonderful book together, and we have her to thank for being able to make our book actually happen, because she had it professionally edited, we had it professionally laid out, and she was able to give us direction in terms of what we needed to do to actually make a successful publication that would showcase the history of the Fairfax County Police Department. Copies of this book are available to the public through a publisher's website, www.historyforall.com. It's available online and it can be purchased there.